Thanks so much. You have been very good MCs. And ladies and gentlemen, friends, colleagues, former students, don't believe a word Hortense said. I'm not that good. I'm just an ordinary colleague in Hong Kong U, but it has been my greatest pleasure to work alongside with Paul. Yes, we played a game of good guy and bad guy. He has the bad job. He has to pretend to be bad. And I have to pretend to be good. That's a lot easier. Right. I'm so glad there are so many of you spend time on a weekend, a long weekend, and come to this historical building, Loke Yew Hall, to share this moment with me. When the students say, we should have a dinner together because I've been waiting for you to go away for 38 years and now I'm not sure we need to celebrate. And I said, look, let's do something more meaningful. And therefore, we started Project Hangaround. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I have a friend who sent me an email. His name is Benford Cole. And in his email at the bottom, he has a monthly reflection. And there's a quote he put down there. The highest reward for man's labor is not what he gets for it, but what he becomes by it. So I have been with Hong Kong U for 38 years. I've never looked at it as a job. I've never looked at it as a career. I look 38 years, and today happens to be my last day. Starting tomorrow, I will still be an honorary professor of two departments of Hong Kong U, but not an employee. So I don't need to listen to what Paul Tam asked me to do, which used to be my work ethics. If I'm an employee, it's my duty to do what I'm asked, unless I cannot do it. Otherwise, whether I like it or not has never been my consideration. But starting tomorrow, whether I like it or not, and sometimes even whether Jane likes it or not, become a point of consideration. But over the years, the only thing that I can do is to count my blessing. I can tell you I have a lot of colleagues working here for Hong Kong U for many years, and by the time they retire, they actually feel bitter and unhappy. But when I look back the 38 years that I have here, I can only count my blessings. And therefore, tonight is an opportunity for me to share my joy and my blessing with friends, colleagues, and students for over many years, so that you can share this joy with me. I once read Steve Jobs, the late Steve Jobs, has said, in life, we encounter people, we went through different incidences, and sometimes those situations, those people that you encounter, they give you the moments that he called the character-defining moments. And in the 38 years that I have in Hong Kong U, and with my family and friends, there has been many, many of my character-defining moments, and they exist because of you. Now, therefore, tonight, I ask you all here not only to share my joy and to join my student that they have been waiting for me to go and they celebrate it, but also an opportunity for me to thank you, all of you, for making who I am and what I am. Now, in so doing, I would like to share with you the three initiatives that I've been very closely involved in the last 10 years or so. And that was the Dream Catchers, the brand, the initiative that brings together all the people who believe innovation and entrepreneurship is our future, and we work hard at it. And I have the Dreamcatchers team here. Dreamcatchers team, please stand up. Come on. So you see, at Hong Kong, we are poor, we have small resources. We have only a few people working. And we also need donations. I have the faith and global engagement team here. Daniel and the rest, where are you? Yes, we are all there. And of course, the Hong Kong Yew Marathon team. Janet, where is Janet? Janet is hiding. Yes, all those national Hong Kong Yew Marathon team, including Ellen Walker, please stand up. I want to thank you for supporting this marathon. But all these initiatives are for people Hong Kong, education is not to get you a piece of paper. I've always been saying that. It's not about grades. It's not about class of honor. It's not about accreditation. I dare say not even about outcome-based learning. It is about the making of a whole person. And therefore, dream catchers is for the mind and the intellect. The Hong Kong Yew Marathon is actually to remind us our physique, our body, and our health are equally important. But beyond all these, our spirituality and our faith and our value and why we do things is what molds us. So it is the body, the mind, and the spirit health, which is what education is about. And we need to bear this in mind. I see that Hong Kong has a tendency to go into a metric-driven society, including university, ranking. How many people publish four-star papers? I'm not saying those are not important, but they are just measurement of health or indicators of health. What a world-class university is, it should never be driven by metrics. It should always be driven by vision, passion, beliefs, and the true value that we have. And today, we call this Project Angelitis. You can see that as you walk up Loke Yew Hall, the candles start lit up. And on stage and on the table, you see all the candles. Ladies and gentlemen, all those candles are for you to take home. We don't want you to come, have dinner, and go home. Please bring the candle and the flame with you. If life is like a candle, I have burned mine for quite a bit, and there's only a very little bit remaining. But it's the flame that we pass on one generation to the next that hopefully make this a better world for all of us. And all of us are responsible. For those who receive a note from me, I did ask you not to bring any gifts for very good reason. Because I believe I have received more than what I deserve. And definitely more than what I need. So if you want to give to Hong Kong Yew. Okay? And actually, the best gift that I can have is your presence and also your being there as part of my life and walk my life's journey with me in the past, now, and hopefully in the future. Now, people, you see that I don't want anyone to say, retirement dinner, celebrate retirement of torture. It isn't. It's Project Angelite. Because today is not just my retirement. I'm going to share this retirement with two of my other colleagues. One of them is Celina. You? Celina, where are you? This is also also Celina Prof. Celina, after serving he was Patrick's assistant as dean, and he was dean, and then Celina actually have been my assistant for many, many years until today, and this is our last day together. And also, I'm celebrating with another colleague, Professor Keith Luke. This is also his last day. Former head of orthopedics, a very good friend, and an excellent professor. Very important for me. He is a very, very good spine surgeon. I have a very bad back. And because of that, I've actually prepared something for Celina and Keith. I have made a pen for each of you. So, Celina, ladies first, could you come up here? It says, this handcrafted majestic squire pen is specially handmade for Celina Yew by her colleagues Porter and Julie 218. To thank her for her assistance and support over the years at the University of Hong Kong. The barrel of the pen is made from Bethlehem olive wood, directly from the holy city of Bethlehem, before polished to its final beauty. The metallic parts of the pen are made of black titanium, plated with 22 karat gold. No, it's only a few micron thick. With a genuine diamond look-alike, Swarovski crystal on the tip clip to give the pen the majestic sparkle. Now, Pete, come on, I've got something for you too. This one, I won't read it. This is not from Bethlehem olive wood. It's a true stone white marble with gold matrix, which is also a squire pen, majestic squire. Thank you. Well, actually, it is with loyal colleagues like Celina and great professors like Keith Luke that make this university great. And we need all of you, all the young professors, to be like them in the future. Well, actually, even now. Now, I would also like to recognize and thank all those who travel long distance to come for this dinner. That includes Dr. Johnson Lau. Johnson, where are you? Johnson changed his schedule, came from LA, just to come to this dinner. An ardent supporter of Hong Kong Yew Biomedicine. And we count on you with your continuous support. And my twin brother, who look very much like me, Peter Cheung. My daughter, Celeste is over there, and she came all the way from London. I'm a student, since graduated in the year 2000, and he came all the way from Intel, Oregon, just for this weekend to come to this dinner. Dr. William Lee over there. William, stand up. Thank you much for coming. And a few visitors from Stanford, Dr. Robert Chang and Dr. Watson Picasso. Robert and Watson, and together with Lee, who are fortunate enough to leave, they have been working with us on the MedTech Hackathon in the last 7 days. Today is the last day, it just finished this morning, and they come over here for dinner. Thanks so much. Without them, we would not have MedTech Hackathon. And Dreamcatcher would be much lesser than what it is now. Thank you. Please continue. And another brother, Jonathan, from Singapore. Where's Jonathan? Yes, Jonathan come all the way from Singapore as well. And I have a kind of fans from Dreamcatcher's Entrepreneurship Academy. She wasn't my student, and she came with her husband. And Sherlock Yun and Dennis Huang, they come all the way from Singapore just to have dinner with us. Sherlock is also a company alumni, and also a member of the Entrepreneurship Academy. And one of my students came from Beijing, Happy Su, she is very happy. Happy came all the way from Beijing. Now, it's not just the evening. I want you to go away thinking about what it meant for you to be associated with Hong Kong U, and in what way you can help Hong Kong U, then Hong Kong, then China, then the world, to be a better place. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks very much.
Thank you, Paul, for the work from the bottom of your heart, crystallizing the 30 years of the Hong Kong youth experience, and also give us some guidance or some food for thought on how to link up our mental self and our physical self. So now, on Yisek Wai Tin, dinner will be served, and then we will come back with more proceedings after the dessert has been served. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.